Hi fairies, and welcome back to my channel. It's Raja Andrea. So in this video, I'm going to be showing you guys my updated version of how I like to do my wigs, lay my wigs, bleach my wigs, dye my wigs, everything that has to do with wigs in 2020 moving forward. So definitely stay tuned for the rest of the video. Okay, so I so lost this clip, you guys. I'm so mad because this was so important. I'm gonna do a separate video of how I like to bleach my lace on my wigs now. It is so hard to explain without showing you guys. All I do is just make it so that it's like an igloo of aluminum foil to make everything bleach evenly. I'll make a whole separate video to get more into detail, because for me to just show a little clip like that, it's just, you know, not doing really justice. I'm gonna do a whole separate video just talking about bleaching the knot. So next thing I'm doing is doing an updated dyeing jet black video. Yes, you guys loved my original jet black dyeing video. So I'm now going to be doing an updated version of 2020. This time, instead of using semi-permanent dye, I'm going to be using permanent dye from the new line of Dark and Lovely. They're fade resistant jet black. They literally just updated everything. They updated their packaging. I don't believe they updated their formula as far as the dyes. But I know that they updated their formula as far as the conditioner. This has been my favorite conditioner of all time, you guys. Oh my god. But we'll get into that later. So the first I'm showing you guys is how I like to pour all of my dyes into one container. I'm telling you, it is so simple, but you know, not many people think that doing it this way. Everyone usually just takes the bottles from the box and just does it each one by one. I'm showing you guys the little tubes that I like to use as far as using this. I will link them down below. But I use a bigger one and then a smaller one. They both are from Salon Care. I know the smaller one takes 2 boxes of Dark and Lovely dye, and the bigger bottle takes 4 dyes from Dark and Lovely dye. So depending on what type of length of your wig, the wig that I'm using today is from Tinashe brand. You guys have seen me use their brand a couple times already. For the wig I'm using today, it took literally 1 big bottle. So that's 4 boxes of the Dark and Lovely jet black dye. And then if I was to be doing like a bob or something like that, like a shorter length, I will use the smaller one from Salon Care Pro, and that takes 2 boxes of Dark and Lovely. So the only thing that's different is I'm using jet black dye as far as the hair, but as far as doing the knots on the lace, it's going to be the same as what I did in my original video. I'm going to be using Kiss Colors, their jet black semi-permanent dye. I tried to do this in another video, but I had to do a whole separate video because when I originally did my updated jet black dye video, I was trying to use the Dark and Lovely dye to do the knots on my lace. I feel like when the dye started actually, like, you know, setting in and getting bigger, and you know, the developer started developing literally on the lace, it got all over the lace. It was like a hot mess, you guys. So I'm gonna stick to doing the same method as far as using the semi-permanent dye from Kiss Colors and using this little feather brush from Salon Care, I believe. The majority of things I'm using is for Dark and Lovely or from Sally Beauty. So definitely, I know Sally Beauty does sell select Dark and Lovely products, but I will see what store really sells the most of Dark and Lovely, and I will link that down below. I just went ahead and did the same technique that I use per usual on doing my lace, and then now moving on to doing the entire wig using a jet black dye. The reason why I use permanent dye now and jet black instead of the semi is because, think about it, you guys, when you have your wigs for a very long time, you obviously wash your wigs. So over time, if you use the semi-permanent like in my other video, and then you're washing your wigs consistently, that semi-permanent is going to fade out, while if you use the permanent dye, you will be able to have the longevity a lot longer of your jet black color. And when I tell you guys, this jet black is so dark, you guys always compliment me on my Instagram pictures and say you have the best dark black hair. It's because I've been using the Dark and Lovely, and this John gets dark, okay? Black Panther vibes. So I'm just going to be putting this all throughout the hair, nothing special, and just making sure that you're being careful around the lace part. That was the whole purpose of us using the semi-permanent, to get it to where I'm not being super close to the lace, and it avoids me getting this permanent jet black on the lace. That was the point of using the feather tool, to make sure that I'm not getting super close to the lace, and I'm able to just move pretty quickly. And I literally took like about 15 minutes to put the dye all throughout the hair. You just want to make sure it's really saturated so that, you know, you're not missing any spots, and just going back and making sure that every single part is saturated with that black dye. And then this is the ending results. This is what everything's looking like. And you guys can see I have zero dye on my lace. It looks perfect. Now I'm going to be letting that sit for about 30 minutes. And then after that 30 minutes is up, I went ahead and rinsed it out and conditioned it. Like I said, I believe that, I don't know if they changed everything about the actual dye and the conditioner, but I do know that the conditioner is new to their product. That conditioner smells so good. I pretty much used that conditioner in my latest two videos that I've had on my YouTube channel, and my pink ombre and my purple and green video. I definitely showed the Dark and Lovely conditioners in both of those videos because this conditioner is a bomb, you guys. It smells amazing, number one. And it has vitamin E and argan oil, so it's super conditioning and nourishing for your hair. It conditions it like crazy, and it makes it so soft. So I advise you guys to go ahead and pick up these Dark and Lovely dyes, because number one, this jet black is dark, honey, as you guys can see, and number two, the conditioners and these dyes are unbelievable and like literally unmatched. Want to fly, fly with you, babe. Let's start a 40 my way to the stars. Want to fly, fly with you, babe. We're going to reach the sky, feel the vibes. Let's start a 40. Alrighty, now I'm gonna move on to doing my updated way of how I like to do my lace wigs using lace glue. So if you guys have not seen my bedhead video, go ahead and check that out, because you guys won't understand my love for the bedhead spray. This has been my go-to spray instead of using the Gatsby. I do not even touch my Gatsby spray anymore. You guys can just see, even wherever I spray the bedhead, it goes directly where I spray it. The hold on it is magnificent, and it's super cheap as far as like the smaller cans. I know you can get 2 for $17 for the bigger cans. I believe the bigger cans are about 10 ounces or 10 fluid ounces on Amazon. I will leave that link below. But yeah, go ahead and check out that bedhead video if you guys have not seen it, because I tell you guys all the tea in that video. I'm going to move on to using a wig cap. I'm going to link this wig cap down below as well. This has been my go-to wig cap. I do not use any other wig cap, because for this specific wig cap material, all the other wig caps that I use, whenever I would have like a full face of makeup and then I try to do my hair afterwards and I put the wig cap on, that wig cap literally took off all of my makeup on my forehead. And this has been the only wig cap that I can actually do my makeup before I do my wigs, because it does not mess up my makeup at all. And I will show you guys in the video what I mean by that. So I'm going to take that bedhead hard head spray yet again, and now I'm going to spray that onto the wig cap. And like I said, I love this spray for the simple fact that the Gatsby, whenever I would do this step, it would get everywhere. But with the bedhead, it sprays directly wherever you literally spray it. And it's just so much better. And the hold is so much better. And you guys will see the hold when I spray on the wig cap. When it dries, this joint is solid. It's solid on my forehead. Like, I never have any problem with my ear portion. Nothing is coming up. But again, that's the whole purpose of the video, is to show you guys exactly what I'm talking about when I say that. Fly with you, babe. We're going to reach the sky. Feel the vibes. Let's start a 40. And then now, when the wet cap is all dry with my blow dryer, I'm just going to cut off the center section of the wig cap. And then as you guys can see, just a little bit of the makeup was altered, but not that much. But it was so much better than any other wig cap, because any other time my entire forehead would be like gone from the makeup. But with this, you guys can barely see just a little bit of my makeup messed up, but nothing too crazy. Now I'm going to move on to using my Huda Beauty Tan Bronzer Cream to Powder Bronzer. Now you guys are probably like, what the hell are you doing with this freaking bronzer? I actually got this trick, not the specific product. I found this product on my own, but I actually got this tip from my friend. He is a celebrity hairstylist. So you guys know my old series, my celebrity hairstylist series. That is because I get tips from a lot of hair people that you guys have seen everywhere, whether it's from Kellen Derrick, Alonzo, Eric and Tay, all these people. I get a lot of tips from them. Cos Spence, they all do celebrity hair. And I either talk to them personally, or I just see their videos or their pictures and things on Instagram and get inspired from those. But a lot of times from the other people personally, they let me know their different tips and stuff that they recommend for me to do. And I got this tip from Kellen Derrick, because when we were in Bali for the EAP heat trip, he showed me to use a cream to powder instead of using a powder foundation to put as far as blending in your skin color for your wig cap, because when you blow dry your wig onto your head using a lace glue, that melt is unbelievable. So I didn't want to use a specific cream to powder product that he uses, because I didn't want to give all the tips away. So I just went ahead and found a cream to powder that I could physically see and match to my skin tone, and it just so happened to be a bronzer from Huda Beauty in the light shade. I know, super crazy, but listen sis, it works, okay? So I just went ahead and put on that cream to powder on my wig cap, and then now I'm just cutting everything off. And like I was telling you guys before, the hold from that bed head on this wig cap is like super bomb. Nothing was coming up, like it was absolutely perfect. I'm gonna go ahead using my Bold Hold Active wig glue. This has been the only wig glue that I like, number one, and number two, the only wig glue that I can really work with, because any other wig glue I've tried, it's just a hot ass mess. And this has been like the only one that I can actually work with and try to understand how it works. And what I found out with the Bold Hold Active is that you can't use too much, and I like to apply it with a wooden spatula I got from the Arts and Crafts store, Michael's, Walmart, anywhere you guys can find any types of arts and crafts, even the Dollar Tree, Dollar Store. They're like a dollar. They're super cheap, but I only use a little bit of the product, and whenever I put it on my wig cap, I put it about 1.5 to 2 centimeters back from my hairline, and then use the wooden spatula to push it forward, and I only do a thin layer. Anytime I have a lot of the active Bold Hold on the spatula, I would just wipe it down on a paper towel that I have in front of me. So I'm going to be using 2 layers of the Bold Hold Active today. So I'm just going to put on 1 layer and let it dry. You guys can see that my glue is drying pretty quickly. That's how you know that you have a good amount of it on. Fly with you, babe. We're going to reach the sky. Feel the vibes. Let's start a party. And then I'm just gonna go ahead and put on my wig, but then we're gonna do 1 more layer of the Bold Hold right before I start to lay the wig down. I like to work in sections when it comes to laying down my wigs. I will first start with doing the front section of my hair, and then I would just start to cut the lace in a couple of sections because it's easier to work in like smaller sections on the lace. I found that out by trial and error, and I would just slowly work into sections, putting on my second layer of the Bold Hope Active, pushing it down on the wig cap and blow drying it, and just doing the same thing all around my hairline. And one note that I want to let you guys know is, remember I told you guys that Kellen was telling me to use a cream to powder, specifically for the reason that when you do the cream to powder and you put down your lace glue and blow dry it on a medium heat, it has to be on medium heat for it to really work and melt down like the ending result. You have to use medium heat. Yes, it gets a little bit hot, sis, but that melt with that cream to powder and the lace glue, it has some type of magical powers because that melt is, you know, it's intense, you guys. Alright, and now we're going to do an added step that I kind of just threw in and I felt like it just works for me. We're going to be using the bedhead spray yet again when it comes to laying down our lace. And this step, I am just so happy I've been doing it because I've had the hardest time trying to understand how to use lace glue. I would not say that I am like the pro at using lace glue. When it comes to using Gatsby or bedhead, listen sis, I know how to lay a damn frontal. But when it comes to the lace glue, I'm still trying to get it and understand it. And I felt like with this video, I learned in my own way how I like to do it and how I like to have it blend on darker skin. Listen, I'm just trying to be honest. When it comes to lighter skin and using transparent lace, we have to tint it, we have to do all these type of tricks for it to really blend in for darker skin. I'm just saying. And I felt like using the cream to powder, using my favorite wig cap on top of using medium heat and using the bedhead spray and parting out your baby hairs in front and using the bedhead spray again to spray, I feel like doing it like that, it just makes it melt so good into your skin and it makes so that the hairline looks a lot more realistic. So all I did was just part out my baby hairs all around my hairline and spray the bedhead spray, and I let that dry with a blow dryer with a black strip for about 5 minutes, and this is the outcome. So all I do now is just take some Morphe scissors. They're about $8. I got them from the Morphe store. I'm just going to start to cut the lace. I love using really small scissors for cutting the lace, just because I can get really close to the hairline and they're not super bulky and I feel like they're just so small and they're perfect for detail work. So I just use these to cut the ear portion. I cut the hairline and I just start to work with my powder brush. I don't have any foundation powder on it. It's just leftover powder from when I was doing it with my makeup. And I just go back and forth by using my hot comb, using some more bedhead spray, and just really working this frontal to make it a lot more realistic. And I felt like this frontal is transparent, but I got it to look so good on my skin tone that it kind of mimics like a HD type of lace lay because that's how melted I got it to be. So I just do the same thing on the other side off camera, I believe. And then I just went ahead to curling it using my Golden Hot 2-inch curling iron. And then I also just parted it and did a few clips on the side, which you guys will see later on. And then I will come back at the end of the video when everything is all done and slayed. Originally had on these sparkly silver clips on the left or right side, and I was actually looking on my little beauty dresser and I saw that I had the same olive color as my jacket in the clips, and I was like, oh my god, these clips go perfect with my entire look. I have my olive eyeshadow, I have my olive jacket, and then I also have my olive clips, and I just felt like this look just came out so freaking cute, you guys. On top of that, I just felt like my frontal slate was just really good. And also I'm going to do a separate video of how I like to bleach my knots evenly, perfectly every single time. I'm so mad I lost that clip in the beginning of the video. I have no idea what happened to it on my memory card, but I will do a whole separate video showing you guys how easily you can get your knots to bleach evenly every single time. I actually learned this trick from my old summer intern. Her name is Serenity. She's actually the one that taught me how to do that. I am not going to take ownership. You guys know I give credit where credit is due. She's the one that taught me how to do that in the summer, especially because she was my intern and she was teaching me how to do things. So shout out to Serenity, because she's the one that gave me all the tea with that. And ever since she taught me how to do that, sis, I've been doing it every single time and it literally works. It's like freaking magic. And I also just added a few more things as far as using the purple shampoo. I added one more product. And yeah, I will do a whole separate video, guys, I promise. But this is how we are coming in 2020, okay? We are getting the frontal laid down for the dark-skinned girls, okay? Represent. So, hope you guys really appreciated and liked this video. I'm going to be coming... Listen, I'm coming crazy in 2020. I can't wait. I get my body done. Well, I get my breast done. I get my breast reduction done in January. I have 2 more weeks. I am so excited. And I will be filming that whole entire process for you guys. So January is going to be crazy, but it's going to be so much fun. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I can't wait to see you guys in my next one. And I will definitely get that bleaching video up for you guys within next week. So yeah. Bye, guys.